Purpose. How are we doing out there, Nitro fans across the globe? Super excited to be here. Look at this playground.
All the time, good start. Pastrana on the outside, but Hansen going to outdrag him down the inside line. Oh, Travis having none of it, going to try and go all the way down the outside in the big Subaru, going to get on the bars, going for the sideways drift. Now he's going to straighten up to the inside line, but Timmy's there just in front. Tightly done by Travis.
Well done. Not knocking on Heaven's door, but knocking on Hansen's door. They both go for the jump, and here we go. Send it full pull to the moon. Not talking Dogecoin. Travis going wide. Let's see how he handles this bank.
Woo-wee! Going for the wide line, going to try and get inside of Hansen. He does. Contact between them, going to cut the inside line. Brilliant move from Estrada. Timmy gets back on the inside line again. Over the jump now, coming up to the braking zone. Travis going to get on the bar. He'll look for the inside line here. Got it done. Timmy runs wide. Pastrana with some brilliant race craft here. Man. Timmy's got the inside of the tarmac.
Look at this mosh pit of a battle here between Hansen and Pastrana. This is just an appetizer, man. This is a blooming onion. Oh, look at that.
Hansen's back on it. He's in real. This is the first time we've seen it from the drone like this. It's actually downhill, meaning it's hard to spot where the inside line is.
Oh!
Hansen Travis. Into the wall. Did Travis push him off?
Let's roll the tape back, my friends. But regardless, checkered flag waves for Travis Pastrana. Here, watch Larson. Now he goes in. Little squeal right there underneath the bridge.
Really looking forward to this. This is the first time we've seen the two Subarus go up against each other. We know they've done all this start testing. Scott did a bunch of that. Does it give them an edge? You know, left, right side of the grid. Andreas Backer was saying they think there's something in that. So here we go. Pastrana versus Speed on the run to turn one. Look for the green. Great start by both of them side by side. Scott Speed's got the edge of Travis. Pastrana going to run him out wide. Pastrana going to go all the way around the outside. And we see Pastrana is the only driver who's not given up if he loses the start. I'll guarantee you he goes with Scott here.
But keep in mind that he said, the team owner says, don't crash out. We know it's your fault, Travis, if they get into a tussle. Both of them going for the big gap here as Scott Speed has the lead. He's got the clean air. Pastrana getting some dust in his face. Let's see what kind of lines he takes. There goes Travis. See if he can dive in like he did on Arpin.
He's going to try the same move, but can't quite get there. Speed carries a little bit more speed around the outside line. Pastrana, though, in the Duke Roost there, completely blinded. But he's right alongside. Speed gets on the brakes. Pastrana rotates the car earlier. Side by side, fighting for traction. Speed just got this. It's so close.
Yeah, amazing execution there. Tanner, we're going to bring you in here. Talk about the course, if you will, how it's transforming. Again, it worsens, right, as more cars are on it. How is it, you know, with a fresh, groomed course compared to when it gets thrashed on?
Yeah, once it gets thrashed on, you got to watch out for the little holes. You can actually see them in the track. You see that blue groove? Looks like there's a lot of grip. There isn't. It's like silt on top of the blue groove. It's amazing amount of discipline for these guys to stick it so close to the tire barrels, especially on the hairpin, which I blew, and don't bring it out there. It's done. We said it.
Oh! Tires. Yeah, Pastrana clips the tires. He's gone with Scott again, so he's done exactly what he did with Timmy Hansen. He's not alternated the Joker strategy. He's going to drive with the pass. He goes deep and high on the brakes. Almost clips the rear corner on the tires on the end of the K-rail. Now clips the inside. That's game over. Scott Speed should take this.
Congratulations, overcoming that PTSD. How'd you change your mindset here earlier to kick off a day like today?
When I'm in the car, I try to just compartmentalize it and drive well. But this was so cool because this is like such an awesome format, the battle qualifying.
He's really good. I've been trying to do my best to learn from him. He's really crafty as well. So he went wide and slowed up. He knew I couldn't get inside, but I was like, oh, he's going Joker. So I backed my turn up, and then he just took off and went for the jump. And I was like, already committed to not doing the Joker. So he's good. I knew I couldn't beat him straight up. So I had to take the race to him. And he backed me up enough where I couldn't get around that I didn't have a chance to jump in there.
Welcome to Utah Motorsports Park, Utah, the state of sport. Round one of five of the Nitro Rallycross Championship. And we are going into supercars. That's right, they got a cape, they fight crime. No, I'm joking. 600 horsepower, all-wheel drive machines. I'm Jarod, DeAnda. Joining me once again, Andrew Coley. Thank you so much, man. The question is, how excited are you, Andrew? But also, let's educate the fans here real quick. What is Nitro Rallycross?
So Nitro Rallycross is Rallycross 2.0. This sport's actually 50 years old. Nitro Rallycross started in 2018, here at the Utah Motorsport Campus. Travis Pastrana, you know what? Rallycross is awesome, but I think I could make it double awesome. I'm going to get the rule book. I'm going to rip some pages out of it.
Light them on fire.
Yeah, we're going to burn some stuff. We're just going to go for big jumps. We're going to go for berms. And that's what he's done. He's created this incredible place. What's even better is, as Jarod's
already said, we're going to go to four more of these tracks this year and see what else has come out of his mind. Here it's NRX next. Kasper Janssen, George McGinnis on the front row. Good start for Kasper, then has to kick the cuts. McGinnis going to get him. Yellow squad driver going to try and shut the door. Ray McKayla P3, Eric Gordon down in P4. McGinnis does shut the door.
These next car races are very aggressive and they are very close.
McGinnis, win round two of NRX Next. Brilliant drive under pressure. The lights have come on to tell him ready to race. Top right underneath the Red Bull branding. There it is. When that goes out, random gap, 2 to 4 seconds. Then we get Sandy. Great start. McCall on the outside line. Scott Speed on the good traction to get a hold of that inside line. Timmy and Kevin Hansen side by side. Kevin Erickson goes inside line into the joker lap. It is Scott Speed straight around to the outside. Not Joker inside, sorry, my bad. It's one of the Peugeots. Timmy, I think it is, with in behind him, Kevin Erickson. It's Scott Speed who goes straight for the gap shot. Fraser McConnell goes with him. And it's, yeah, so Timmy's got Joker in the background. And we've got a slow car. Liam Doran is at the back of the pack over the big hit.
All right, as Scott Speed clears out that jump, and it looks like one of the Hanson boys is out front. And look at that, the old Verge Honda. So we got Timmy Hanson up front, Kevin Erickson, Scott Speed. That is your 1, 2, and 3. Now going to that step up. Now remember, this is lap 1 of 5. There's plenty of racing. Look at already. Dusty, look at how aggressive these gentlemen are driving, but bringing up the rear, very surprisingly, what do we got?
It's my bad, it was Ollie Erickson that went in the Joker. 3 Red Bull color cars and a bit of dust, but yeah, my bad. The 2 Hansons as well, so it's Timmy Hansen leading from Kevin Erickson in P2. What's going to be key here? What Scott was saying is about adapting to the track. Ollie Erickson's gone Joker early. He's hoping he's going to adapt to the track quicker than these guys. They're going to be caught in a bit of a battle. 3 cars split off to the right-hand side now. So that is Timmy Hansen. Is he going to respond and go Joker straight away, or is he going to go for the big hit again into the right? Watch for the car attitude. And he's heading to the... He's gone for the big hit, gone for the jump.
All right, the Red Bull high flying over that big gap as Timmy Hansen, Erickson there in second. And it looks like the tire fail is absolutely right in the way. We saw a driver, so when they go into that jump lane, there is a tire pail right in the middle, and Timmy Hansen still leads the pack. Scott Speed, getting a little love tap there.
Yeah, Kevin's got him. Kevin Erickson's got him with the contact.
All right, so Timmy Hansen continues on. Look at this, 1.9 seconds. The leaders of the pack, the top.
Oh, Erickson's off. Hit the barrier on the inside.
Yep. Oh, man. So here we are. Those tire barrels are absolutely getting in the way. But Timmy Hansen, you know what? He's like, you guys do whatever you want behind me. I'm going to go ahead and get this clean air and get out of the way. So I think strategy here is for Timmy. Let's go hit that Joker lap on that last lap.
Yeah, I think he'll stay out front as long as he possibly can. He goes standard. Interestingly, it looks like Scott Speed's gone for the low line. We've barely seen anyone doing that. So Speed's gone for the low tabletop. But Hansen's there. Erickson goes through to row 2. Brilliant by them. Everybody else, they're going to have to come back out, Jarod. They're going to go semi-finals. Great launch, Pastrana, not so good for Arpin. Ollie Bennett's gone forward. So Tanner still all the way to the back of the pack, down towards Dunlop. Pastrana goes inside. Faust gone with him back. We'll have a look at the inside of Tanner Faust. Sorry, inside Ollie Bennett. He's got him. So he gets Bennett contact in the background. It's the 2 Subarus leading 3 cars out to the right-hand side. We'll see if any go Joker. But at the minute, it's Pastrana from backward. And backward, the big winner there. He's up 2 rows.
Nice job over that tabletop jump. So look at this, the tabletop being utilized. This is, as you said, a formula that none of the drivers are going for. Bigum takes that Joker lap as Pastrana is leading the pack with the clean air. Andreas backwards in a second. Subaru 1 and 2.
Yeah, Ollie Bennett getting beaten up in the background there. Another bit of contact. I'm not quite sure who was in behind him. It might be Larson. It might be Faust. That's a nice look. It's Faust. Larson looks to get past Faust. Can't. Cabot Bigum's off the back of this pack because he's the only driver who jokered. So 8.4 off. We think it's about 5. He's going to put him in the mix, but maybe not to go straight through. Top 2 go through. Pastrana wants it.
Pastrana definitely wants it. He's feeling the flow. He's got a lot of momentum yesterday, getting second place overall in the bracket battle.
So Speed had won his heat race. He'd have been on pole. Timmy Hansen was down in P5. So front row for Travis Pastrana because he was ahead in the battle. He will be pole in the final.
6 vehicles, only 2 advanced. Who's going to be watching from the grandstands after this is over? That is the big ask here. Coley, Hansen, Bennett, Erickson, Doran, Larson, Bigum.
Here we go then. Is Bennett going to pull off a great start and out-drag Kevin down? Jump at the back, I reckon, for Robin Larson. I might be wrong, but Robin Larson, I think, went early. We'll have to see what the stewards think. If not, it's an absolute banger of a start. He goes straight up the inside of Kevin Erickson. Inside lap then is Kevin Hansen, Robin Larson, and Kevin Erickson. Doran's gone around the outside. Let's see whether or not they go Joker straight away. Ollie Bennett goes Joker. Doran's gone jump. So Doran's gone for the gap jump in the back.
background. That's the right thing to do. Didn't want to follow Ollie here.
Yeah, absolutely excited there. Jarod making it exciting. Dropping on in. Can he get that P2 position? That's what he's about to go for. Going around the outside, but Hansen still has that lead. And honestly, we also saw Katabiga. He pulled off.
P2 though. That's a great move. He managed to get his teammate Larson with that super long jump. So that does prove, at least on lap one, that the gap jump is an option. Oh, Larson's back alongside Doran now, and the track to drop back in.
And remember, look at this. We've seen Doran and Larson go door to door. They're teammates. But guess what? Third is going to be watching from the outside. Doran, Larson, that's the spot you need to be looking for. They're fighting for the spot.
Oh, Liam Doran's car shredding parts. It's broken on the rear. Liam's in the wall. Rear left puncture. He puts the car in the wall. Doran's out. The battle's over. It's Kevin Erickson now versus Larson. Kevin Erickson's going to, there's Liam. He's in the wall. He'll be fine. Down at turn one, they're around the outside line. Has gone Kevin Erickson. They're going to split the strategy here. They have to.
Unbelievable. Unfortunate for Liam Doran. He was looking so good. That puncture sends him into the wall. But now it's Hansen and Larson. Erickson there in third. You can see it just about a second in between those second and third.
Jarod Bennett's joking. He's on.
Oh, we got a roll. We got a roll there from Larson. Larson goes over, but then rubber meets the asphalt. He survives and continues on, but he is back quite a distance. Hansen and Erickson, one and two. These guys saw the most calamity here in this LCQ.
So now we need to figure out whether or not it will be a restart, and then who can restart. Liam won't because his car's damaged. Kevin will. I want to see if Larson might restart, Jarod. After rolling the car, imagine if he rolls the car, restarts, and then makes the final. That'd be a hell of a story. But he was limping, so not sure.
Don't go anywhere. Guess what? We're re-racking them. They're going three laps once again in LCQ.
Bennett versus Kevin Hansen on the front. Remember, three more laps again. Good start. Bennett's got a better start this time. Going to squeeze Kevin Hansen on the run down to turn one. Ollie Bennett going to go inside line. He's got Kevin Hansen. If he runs wide, Kevin will get on the inside. He does exactly that. Hansen makes the pass. Around the outside line has gone both Larson and Bigham. I can't see who's in front in the dust. It looks like Bigham. Larson drop back to Cabot. Bigham, where's he going to go? He goes jump.
Look at this. Ollie Bennett, one more turn as he re-enters on the tarmac, where Liam Doran, the Doran turn here as he crosses and gets the checkered flag. Kevin Hansen is going to the big show.
Bigham's gone running in the background.
Oh, no.
Bigham's broken the car. He's going around in circles. Larson's way too far back. Steering's broken on the Audi.
Come on,
he's in the wall.
Come on,
oh, he's
got
it. Come on. He's
got it. There
he goes. The team have got some work to do now.
I'm actually very surprised that we have this many cars finishing.
It was madness, wasn't it, on the run to the turn one. So five cars went out wide, and from that, Jarod, I'm looking to see who went Joker, because when you're in a train of five like that, it's not ideal. Timmy managed to get speed to be in turn one. I need to see turn one again as well and see if there was any. Was it Pastrana who went in front of Timmy? That's there.
That was speed.
I need to see the start again. Maybe we can take a look at him. This with Ollie
Love
Erickson.
That.
Do you reckon
Ollie.
He took the gap? I think he must have done to come in that hot. He must have taken the gap jump.
Yeah, Ollie got so aggressive in that Team Ulbricht vehicle.
This was Arpin's jump pass on McConnell. Absolutely brilliant. In the background, I think his speed is Kate's the jump on the way down. Kevin's already up into P6 at this point. Double podium for the Hansons again. Yeah,
the Red Bull Hansen NRX team, Peugeot of Timmy Hansen.
We're celebrating like you just won a championship. A big comeback here today. This whole weekend.
like you said, we did it again. It's just unreal. I love this racetrack. I love my race team. And it's been such a good event.